Hey guys, how are you all? My name is Harsh Devedi, friends, and I welcome you back to my video. So in this video, friends, I will be discussing with you the Lucknow Pact of 1916. See, friends, this Lucknow Pact of 1916, this was basically an agreement between the Indian National Congress and Muslim League. And this changed actually the whole situation at that point of time. It actually recognized that Hindu and Muslims are two different communities. They have two different requirements, and it was actually a failure for both of them. It was actually a win for Muslim League for their objective, but it was a big loss for the Indian National Congress. So before starting, friends, this video is in English. So if you are not comfortable with the English version, kindly go to the Hindi version of the video. The link of the Hindi version of the video is given in the description box below, friends. Also, friends, if you want to follow me on Instagram, my profile link of Instagram is given in the description box below. So you can also follow me there. So starting with it, friends, it was an agreement, as I've already told you, between Indian National Congress and Muslim League when their joint session occurred in Lucknow in December 2016. Now, what happened through this agreement, that when this agreement was signed, it was said that minorities, whatever their proportion is in the population, they will give representation in excess of that proportion. That will, they will get over representation in provincial legislatures. This was being told. For example, if Muslims form 25% of the population, they may be given more than 25% seats in the legislature. Also, it was said that at that point of time, this thing came in 1916. World War One was going on. 1914 to 1918 was World War One. So at this point of time, demand of the Indian National Congress was dominion status. Complete independence was not the demand at that point of time. Complete independence demand came through the Pooran Swaraj resolution of 1930, but here the demand was only dominion status. So Muslim leaders, the Muslim League leaders, said to the Indian National Congress leaders that we will support you in your demand for autonomy. In, you know, return for it, we want this thing. That is whatever is discussed through the Lucknow Pact. So this was basically cited as a consociational practice in Indian politics. This means that a practice which involves partners, two partners who are working for mutual benefit. So this was the type of thing, friends, but it was an utter failure. We will see how this was an utter failure. Now, why Lucknow Pact was signed? This is the first thing. See, World War One was going on, friends. And at that point of time, the Britishers, when they were involved in a war, Indian leaders saw it as an opportunity to get some concessions from the Britishers. So obviously, the demand for dominion status was strengthened. Now, at that point of time, the Viceroy of India, Lord Chelmsford, said that please give some reform suggestions. They asked for reform suggestions from the Indian leaders. And in return for the reform suggestions, and he also said that we will give you reforms, but in return we want the support of the Indians in our war efforts. Now at that point of time, the Muslim League, led by Muhammad Ali Jinnah, wanted to use this opportunity to press for constitutional reforms through a joint Hindu-Muslim platform. So Muhammad Ali Jinnah was very active at that point of time. He said that if the Viceroy is asking for reform suggestions, what we can do is that we can present a combined Hindu-Muslim platform, and through which we can press for constitutional reforms in which all the communities are taken care of. And at that point of time, Jinnah was member of both Indian National Congress and also the Muslim League. So he was said to be the responsible, highly responsible for this pact, for this, you know, Lucknow Pact, which was signed between INC and Muslim League. Now see here, friends, in December 1915, many extremists and moderates of the Indian National Congress met the Muslim League leaders at Bombay. And this was the first joint session of Indian National Congress and Muslim Leagues. And at this joint session, both sides' leaders agreed on a set of constitutional reforms. What constitutional reforms to be done, what provisions will be there, and how we will move forward together in order to get our aim of dominion status. So this all things were discussed here. And on October 1916, 19 elected Indian members of the Imperial Legislative Council addressed a memorandum to the Viceroy seeking reforms. So after this thing, this agreement was done between both the South, 19 members of the Imperial Legislative Council, they moved to the Viceroy for asking for reforms. Then again, deliberations happened in November 1916, and in this deliberations, both Indian National Congress and Muslim League at their respective annual sessions at Lucknow in December 1916 confirmed the agreement. Now, whatever deliberations, whatever analysis, whatever plans that were being making till now, all of these plans were ratified by both the Indian National Congress and the Muslim League at their respective annual sessions, which was held in Lucknow in December 1916. This is not November 2016, this is November 1916. I'm really sorry for it. It is actually by mistake written here. So this agreement historically came to be known as the Lucknow Pact. Okay. And when this pact was signed, Sarojini Naidu said that Jinnah is the ambassador of Hindu-Muslim unity. But this thing was grossly incorrect. It was an exaggeration. It was short-sightedness. Both, all the Indian National Congress leaders were not able to see that what they are doing. They were only communalizing the issue. By giving, you see, I will tell you the provisions of this thing. By, you know, giving over representation to the minorities is not wrong. Okay, friends. But actually, when you are doing this, then you are considering that both the minorities, that is Hindu and Muslims in India, are separate. They have separate requirements. They are not one people. Because when you are doing this, you are officially giving this condition that these two people are not the same. They are different. Moving forward, friends, we are going to look at the provisions of the Lucknow Pact of 1916. The first provision of the Lucknow Pact of 1916 is that self-government in India should be there. That is the dominion status. That has been the demand. Then Indian Executive Council to be abolished. This was the second demand. Then separating executive and judiciary. This was a very important demand. Executive and judiciary has to be separated, because at that point of time, the district magistrate collectors used to have the revenue collection powers, the judicial powers, and the executive powers also. Today, the district magistrate only has executive powers. And today only you can see how powerful he is. So just imagine at that point of time when the district collector and executive authorities used to have all the three powers, revenue, executive and judiciary, how much powerful they would have been at that point of time. So this was a good demand. Then it was said that the heavy expenses and salaries of the Secretary of State for Indian Affairs were paid from the Indian coffers. They should not be paid from the Indian coffers, from Indian tax money. They should be paid from the British tax money, from the British Treasury and not from the Indian Treasury. Now, one more demand was 1/3 membership to be given to the Muslims in the central government. Now, this was a problem, friends. Point was that population of Muslims was not 33% or 1/3 of the total population of India. But still, it was said that 1/3 representation should be given to the Muslims in the central government. Now, actually, why this happened, this we need to think. See, friends, what was happening that through the Morley Minto reforms of 1909, separate electorates were brought in. Now, this separate electorate said that if a Muslim candidate is standing on a Muslim street, then only Muslims will vote for him. So, this was grossly incorrect. Why it was correct? See, friends, in an area, suppose a Muslim is standing in an election, or Hindu standing, or suppose a Muslim is standing. Now, only Muslims are voting for him. But obviously, in that area, not only Muslims are living there, Hindus also living, Christians also living, Parsis also living, Sikhs also living, Jews also living. So, obviously, that Muslim person is not only answerable to the Muslim population, he is answerable to all of the people living in that area. He has to work for all of the people living in that area and not only for the Muslims. So if only Muslims are going to vote for him, then he will be answerable only to the Muslims. So that was grossly inadequate. And Britishers knew that this is incorrect. This was a deliberate effort on the part of the Britishers to break India into small parts. Okay. So sort of communalization sort of thing was done by the British. So what Indian National Congress and Muslim League thought, that by the Lucknow Pact we will do the same thing and we will outsmart the Britishers. They didn't knew that they were doing the wrong thing, friends. By giving 1/3 membership to the Muslims, this was actually not wrong. Giving representation to Muslims is not wrong if they are underrepresented. But if you are just recognizing that, okay, 33% of the seats are yours, then you are saying that they are different people than the Hindus. That is, Muslims are different, Hindus are different, and Muslims and Hindus have been living in India for thousands of years together. Their cultural practices, everything has been, you know, complementary to each other. There has been no clashes until and unless politics got involved in this thing. And yes, by doing that, they recognize that, yes, Muslims have separate demands, Hindus are separate demands, so those demands should be dealt with separately, and therewith all problems became. See, reservation, this is a sort of reservation, friends, and reservation without reason is not correct. Today also you can see, friends, whenever any person is having some sort of extra elite privilege, he is not going to leave that privilege. This is the fact. you, today also you can see in the reservation system in India, the top tier people of the depressed classes who have gone to a particular position, even some scheduled caste or scheduled tribe log who have become IAS officers, IPS, IFS, their son and daughters are also taking reservation. Ideally, they should not take it. And those scheduled caste and depressed classes who are living in villages, they don't have money to it, they don't even know about what reservation is. Actually, the reservation is for them. But who is taking the benefit of it? The top class, you know, the elite class. So this is something, friends, that one, when someone has an advantage, he will not easily leave that advantage. Why advantage, friends? In the LPG gas cylinder scheme, see, friends, you get a subsidy of around 250-300 rupees. The people now are not even ready to leave that subsidy. Those people also who are earning quite a handsome amount of money, they were not even ready to leave that 250 rupees subsidy. How can people leave things like this one-third representation and things like these? So obviously this sort of practice was not good for the Indian freedom struggle, but unfortunately it happened. Then it said that number of Muslims in all the provincial legislatures, their number would be decided. Obviously, each provincial legislature was having different number of seats. So how many Muslims will be there in those seats? It was to be decided through this Lucknow Pact. Then it said that separate electorates for all communities until a joint electorate is divided by all. Now see, friends, Morley Minto reforms has already divided the society on the basis of electorates. Now this thing was again doing that. You are dividing the society on the basis of electorate. You should say that there should be no separate electorate. All the people are same. Even if a Muslim person is standing, everybody should vote for him. Now they are saying that every community will have different electorate. Now the Sikhs will have a separate electorate, Jams will have separate electorate, everybody will have separate electorate. So that was not wrong. And who will demand joint electorate if they are having their own separate electorates? And also at the end, a system of weightage for minority representation. Minority representation means weightage. That means that whatever the proportion of the population of the minorities is there, the seats allotted to them will be more than proportion. This is basically weightage for minority representation. That is, minorities will be given more representation than their share in the population. Then the next thing was that the term of the legislative council to be increased to 5 years, and half of the members of this imperial legislative council will be Indians. All elected members to be elected directly on the basis of adult franchise. On the basis of adult franchise means that above a particular age level, all people will be eligible to vote. So this was a good thing. And all elected members will be elected directly by the people and not nominated or indirectly elected. Also, it is said that in the provincial legislatures, around 4/5, that is 80% of the people will be elected and around 20% will be nominated. And the members of the legislative council will elect their president themselves. So this was one more thing. Now, what was the outcome of Lucknow Pact? This I have already told you. It just gave us an impression of Hindu-Muslim unity, which was very, very superficial in the national political scene. And it was very, very short-lived. Because for the time being, by doing this thing, you have combined the Hindus and Muslims. But in future, you will see that now Muslims saw that now my 33% representation is there. Now, in future, anything which involves less than 33% will lead to a clash between Hindus and Muslims. So it actually communalized the whole issue of representation. Also, this I have already told you, that this confirmed that Hindus and Muslims are two different people with two different requirements. And this was not very good, friends. But this thing came out to be a booster for Muslim League. Muslim League was a big benefiter by this thing, friends. Because at that point of time, Muslim League was not a very prominent organization. It was trying to get up. Now, this platform gave Muslim League the boost it wanted. Now, Muslim League became the undisputable leader of the Muslims in India. At that point of time, it was not. Indian National Congress was also having Muslim leaders, friends. How was Muslim League the representative of Muslims of India at that point of time? This pact gave them the boost to become the leader of the Muslims of India at that point of time. Now, see, friends, these views are actually very logical. It is not to hurt any special community or some type of thing, friends. this communalization issue has led to the partition of India, sad partition of India. So what happened at that point of time, what situations arose, that participation, that partition happened, this I have told here. I hope this video was liked by you, friends. If it was liked by you, kindly subscribe to my channel, like this video, and please share this video more and more with your friends who are studying. Thank you for watching my video, friends. Any suggestions are most welcome in the comment box below. Goodbye.